Are you already sewing? Or do you want to learn? Welcome to Power Sewing.
I use a lot of bias binding on things, and I know there is a way to cut continuous bias that saves a lot of fabric. And Ron, I can never remember what it is. And so, but Ron knows this method, and he's going to show you right now.
You're going to love this. You got to see it to believe it. I have a 16 and a half inch square piece of fabric here, Sandra. This is going to give me 142 inches of continuous bias at an inch and three quarters wide. Can you believe it just from this?
So that means that if you wanted to do bias all around something, if you just bought a half a yard, you could do double that.
Can you imagine the cost of if you have a really expensive fabric like Dupioni silk, Dupioni, and you want to trim like a bedspread or something? So this is the way to do it. So here we have a 16 and a half inch square piece of fabric. I'm going to mark the top and the bottom of this square like so. And you're going to mark it on the right side.
Okay.
Then I'm going to take a ruler and I'm going to go make a cutting line. And I'm going to first mark this from...
diagonal.
Yeah, from corner to corner. Okay, Sandra, you grab the scissors there and we're going to cut this. So it doesn't matter which corner you go from.
Okay.
So there we're going to cut it. And once we get it cut, what we're going to do is we're going to sew this right sides together. So make sure you're somewhat perfect on this. I know for Sandra, she might struggle with this, but you're going to love this, honestly.
I know. Sometimes I am willing to be a perfectionist. Not often, but All right, there it is.
Okay, so
I just had to goof it up a little.
Oh, that's fine. So here's our little square at the top.
Okay.
And you're going to put the square at the bottom to the top. So it's going to go like so. Okay. Now, when we sew this seam here, this is going to be sewn at a quarter inch.
So it's right sides together?
Right sides together. And you see how it's offset by a quarter inch?
Yes.
That's what you want. You don't want this looking... like so. You want to bring it back so you start sewing in that little V.
The V, so the quarter,
Okay, so off to the machine we go. And I'm just sewing this with a regular stitch length with a quarter inch seam allowance. So let's make sure I'm at a quarter inch here. Right sides together. And I'm just going to bring my needle over a little bit to the right to give us that quarter inch. And secure this with a little reverse stitch, because you don't want this continuous bias to start coming undone, because then you're going to have a real problem. And this is done with
quarter inch seams. Okay.
And it's amazing how you're going to get 142 inches of this fabric. And as you can see, as I'm coming to the end of the seam, I'm coming out on that little V. Okay, so now we have...
Let's see that little V right there a second before you pull that away.
There we go. See how I've come out a little V right there?
Okay.
And what this does is when you press this seam open and flat, it is a nice continuous edge.
Okay.
So we might have to go over to the iron here and press this, because I don't know if this will finger press. What do you think, Sam?
I think so.
We might be able.
But ordinarily, you would want to go to the iron.
Yes.
Here.
So what we're going to do now
is... hot little handies. We can make this. Okay.
So we have that looking like so. So because... Now let's mark our... cutting line. So
okay.
When you mark your cutting lines, you're going to be doing this, Sandra, because you're good at this. An inch and three quarters, but when you mark that, make sure you see this is on the straight of grain, it doesn't stretch, and this one's on the bias. You want to start on the bias edge and make your inch and three quarters lines throughout.
So you could say it was the edge that crosses the seam.
Exactly. So you're making these cutting lines.
So 1 3/4.
1 3/4.
All right.
Start right at the top, come down.
Okay. And our little finger press seam.
Mm-hmm.
It still doesn't seem like we can make that much from this, and we're not drawing that many lines.
That's right. You could also do this with striped fabrics. You see, then you won't have to do your drawn lines here for cutting.
Well, you know, I always look for cool stripes to do piping with. And, you know, especially ones that have multicolors in. And it's not a bad idea just to cut some bias up, because that kind of makes you creative. You put it in there and you think, oh, I'll just pop it in between, you know, the lining and the facing.
Oh, I love doing that.
Yeah, it's just... I think all those things you don't do for anybody else. You just do it for yourself.
I don't sew for other people. I don't think that I get more enjoyment of sewing for myself than I do for other people.
But you know, lots of people, they say, you know, do you save money to sew? I don't. Yes and no. I'd say I don't save money by sewing, but because I have really good taste, you know, and so I buy really nice fabric. But if you didn't have, you know, if you didn't care what you wore too much, then you probably, it's cheaper not to sew. But it's so much fun.
It is. I don't do it for the economics of it. I just do it for the pleasure.
Okay. So there you go. What do you think?
So that looks good. Now you can see we have a little bit here left over. So let's cut that off.
Okay.
Because we don't want that to be involved in this.
Okay. I was wondering if either I mismeasured or something to get this off. Okay.
So off that comes, even if you have to, even taking off a quarter inch if need be. Okay, there we go. So now we have our piece of fabric, and here's the bias. And now what we're going to do is we're going to sew this end to here. So we're going to do that right sides together. Now when you do this, you are matching up those lines. Now as you do this, everything looks kind of off and weird.
It does.
So what you're going to do here, you see a lot of times when you do this, you'd want to match up line to line, but that's exactly what we're doing. But we're going to offset this
by one
line. So instead of going from the first line, Let's unfold this again. So you're not doing, you see, you're not sewing it this way. Is that clear?
Right.
Okay, you're going to offset this like so.
Now, when these lines go together, see, because they're going at a different angle, it's important where they meet,
right? That's
right.
They have to meet at that core. They have
to
meet at this drawn line. So don't match up like so. So you're actually dropping that by a quarter inch, aren't you?
Right. So see, if you put a pin in, I think that'll show.
Which we don't have. So I'm pretty good at this. So I'm just going to hold it taut, take it over to the machine, and sew it.
So what we're saying is where these two joints, where they come together at a quarter inch, that joint should be matching up.
Okay. That's right. Now we're off to the machine. We're going to sew this right sides together with a quarter inch seam allowance. And like we've done before, start off with a little reverse stitch. Now remember, you're matching up cutting line to cutting line. So let's fold this back there just to...
But also where the joint of the drawn thing, they should be matching. And
that's
I'll
right.
be giving you a test because when I cut it apart, I'll see if you didn't
how
match
accurately.
Them up. And it looks kind of a mess here. I mean,
you think
it's not really going to be happening.
The thing is, if you don't offset it by one line, you're just going to get like big rings of fabric. It'll be like calamari rings is what it lands up to be. Okay, so let's just take...
So this is how it looks now.
Okay.
And so we start cutting it.
But let's just, before we start cutting, let's just lay it flat.
Okay.
And I would take and press this.
Yeah, but we'll finger press it, you'd get
press.
This nice and flat.
Okay, now Sandra, what you're going to do is you're going to start cutting right on this line here. Don't cut through the layer underneath, please. There we go.
Okay. You're awfully demanding.
Well,
here.
You know, so you've got to teach these old dogs.
You know,
you
used to be a chef. You used to be a chef, and I bet you were bossy. Were you bossy as a chef?
No, I don't think so.
Did you have many people quit?
No, not at all.
I bet you did. I bet you had
a fun guy to be around.
I bet you were fun, but you're a little bossy. Just a little bit. I'm a little bossy, too, so I understand.
Well, the thing is, we've known each other for so many years, we just say what's on our mind,
Whoops.
Don't we?
Now, this is the part that probably, if you were going to take your time doing it. Now, you see, when I come to the seam joint, Ron did a perfect job, I have to say. You have done a lot of this because...
Well, it has to start off with the cutting lines, right? Marking your cutting lines. If you don't have decent cutting lines, then you could get totally lopsided.
And I have.
Would you have to
No, you don't have to be on the... It doesn't have to be on the bias.
Because it has a four-way stretch.
Because it has the four-way stretch, okay. Yeah. But you could do it with a knit, sure. And, you know, that's really kind of nice. You could, you know, wool jersey comes in so many colors that it's wonderful to do a bunch of this in wool jersey. But, you know, but see, and also a knit, I don't know that I'd go to all this trouble. I would just cut going straight across because it's 60 inches wide.
And it has a four-way stretch or
and
two-way stretch.
Yeah, I would just cut it. What's the difference between two and four way?
Well, it's the same. I think it depends if you live in Canada or the States.
Two way stretches both directions. Four way means it stretches
in four directions.
Yeah. But really, it's the same. Okay.
Now, I would never use this strip with heavy fabrics, lightweight and medium weight fabrics, but nothing heavy.
Because the joint would be too thick.
Well, you wouldn't use it for Hong Kong or bound, right?
Oh, right.
So here now we have 142 inches of continuous bias.
Now, I see we've got a seam joint here. Would you try to avoid that?
Well, if you're really tight for fabric, you could use it, right? But once you do
I guess
something
that's
like
true.
That, you only see that, right?
See, the nice thing is now all your seams are on the bias. You can wrap some piping around it. And so you're just keeping little bags and everything.
You're just keeping little bags. So
pretty
this
nice.
Is how you get all this bias strip from a 16 and a half square piece of fabric.
And, you know, on our website, there are a couple of charts that we're going to give you because Ron found them on a quilting website about the width of the, if you want a thicker bias strip and you want just a wider piece of fabric. I mean, you gave me this one, like if you're doing a bedspread and you had a 38-inch square, you could cut 4-inch strips from 38 inches that would yield 342 inches of 4-inch strips.
So we're going to have this all on the Power Sewing website.
Yeah, that would be perfect.
Well, I think this is a great little show.
It
don't
is.
You?
Yeah, I know. Once you see it, it's pretty easy.
Well, thanks to all the quilters, we know how to do continuous bias.
So, what do you think?
About what?
Power Sewing.